In the 1920s, the slogan Thirst Knows No Season was first established by the company to help sell Coca-Cola in the wintertime. The image of that Santa is very different from the image that Hayden's son Bloom did for us in 1931. When you see that image, what Sunbloom did, you see this beautiful, holly, jolly, elf-like character with beautiful red cheeks. He's wearing his red coat with white fur trim, and he's always holding a bottle of Coca-Cola or a glass of Coca-Cola and offering it to the person who's looking at the picture. What is remarkable about the Sunbloom paintings from 1931 to 1964 is that you can see the evolution of technology and cultural markers in the paintings. In the very beginning, in the 30s, Santa is painting wooden toys, which would have been given as gifts during that time period. During World War II, Santa has a sack of toys on his back, and in that sack, you can see there are war bonds for sale. And by 1964, Santa is sitting on the floor and he's playing with an electric helicopter, an electric train. What's wonderful about this new campaign is that it includes elements that have happened in other advertising. It includes Santa Claus, the Christmas truck, and it ends with a heartwarming family scene, which is the core of the Coke advertising. What's interesting is that we have consumers who will call the company asking if we invented Santa Claus. And what we tell them is that we didn't invent him. We invented what you think he looks like. And that really is what's so important about the advertising during the holiday season for the company. It reflects culturally what's happening from Santa Claus to the polar bears, and it's a time for family to reflect and think. It's about building memories and building family times and family traditions, and Coca-Cola is honored to be part of that.